I'm Allie Carter, and I'm the author of the Gallagher Girls series. I am absolutely in love with Cayman. People have been so warm and so welcoming. The weather and the landscape is so beautiful, and I absolutely love this bookstore. It is a gorgeous store. This has been a really great tour. I've been really fortunate. I haven't had any bad travel experiences. All my memories so far have been good. I think one of the biggest is going to be tonight, sort of magical place and meeting all kinds of new readers whom I've never come in contact with before.
I really liked it, and I thought she was a really good book writer, and she was really good, and I'm inspired to write a book when I'm older.
I've read the first book, I Tell You I Love You, But Then I Have to Kill You, and I really enjoyed it, so I'm going to try to read the second books and read all the other ones.
I think she's a very good book writer, and I think that I would really enjoy one of her books. I really want to write one of my a book of my own when I grow older, so I hope her books will really inspire me.
You know, when you start writing, you never really know if you're going to be successful or not. And to be honest, the odds are not. Everyone starts off with very small goals. You know, goal one is to get a literary agent to read your stuff and say you aren't terrible. Goal two is maybe an agent will say you're actually kind of good. Goal three is an agent says, yes, I will represent you. So they're very much baby steps along the way. That I was ever able to sell a book at one time was just, you know, the greatest accomplishment I could possibly dream of. That I'm still doing it now, 7 or 8 years later, kind of blows my mind. That I get to do it on this level and actually go on international book tours and actually get to meet readers all over the world is greater than I could ever have possibly imagined. I think that what's going on in the YA genre right now is easily the best stuff going on in books. Everybody, of course, knows the big phenomenon titles. You know your Hunger Games, and you know John Green, and what amazing things are happening for him right now. And you also have a lot of people who are also performing at a very, very high, very consistent level. So one of my favorite authors, in addition to one of my favorite people, is Holly Black. I noticed you have a copy of the Curse Worker series here in the store. White Cat is the first book in that series, and it is possibly one of my favorite books of all times. She is just a master and so incredibly brilliant, and what she did with that series was amazing. I also really, really love Jennifer Lynn Barnes, who has a new series coming out in November called The Naturals. I had the privilege of reading it early, and it's the best book I can possibly recommend to readers of my Gallagher Girls book. Teens today have really amazing authors and really amazing books that they can be reading, whereas even just 20 years ago when I was a teenager, that wasn't really an option. And, you know, I like to joke that I went straight from Berenstain Bears to Barbara Taylor Bradford because there really wasn't much in the YA section. And now teens today have that, and I'm really grateful for that every day. Most of my spare time is spent writing or reading or thinking I should probably be writing or reading. We're all kind of a little bit of workaholic, just a smidge. I do love to cook. I love to swim. I love to go to movies. That's probably my favorite pastime. If I have a free afternoon and 10 bucks in my pocket, I'm probably gonna be at the cinema. And so I love just watching stories come to life. And that's about the only time when I can ever stop thinking about my books and my stories and actually turn my head off, and is to go and sort of get immersed in somebody else's story.